Mama, I need to. We need to have.
It's fucking after school special roll call bullshit. Hi, it's Trixie Mattel.
I'm Katya.
And we are two queens who like to watch.
Yes, we are.
Today we're gonna watch Heartstopper Season 2, a Netflix original program based on a very popular graphic novel about teen queer romance.
Right, not about cardiac arrest, which is equally as exciting.
This show's about high schoolers, and just like high school, when you think it's over, it comes back for another year.
There you, oh, bam.
So whether or not you're on board with PG-13 portrayals of queer love, here we are.
I think it might even be PG, how about that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, while there might not be any nudity, you can find that on my OnlyFans. Now, there's gonna be spoilers, so watch the show and come back to us and we'll regroup.
The number of gay men I know who watch this? Zero.
Well,
the number of straight girls who I know who watch this? 5 million. Let's catch up with those homosexual teenagers.
Heartstopper.
You're just gonna ignore me for 2 weeks then.
Nick has study hall and has a seat assigned right next to Ben.
I said sorry to Charlie for what happened.
Don't talk about him.
Well, do you remember this drama? Do you remember?
I remember.
By the way, you can tell these are real teenagers because time has gone by. These people look different.
Time does go by.
But these people look different.
Yeah. They're growing up right before our very eyes, just like on Beverly Hills 90210.
I got you a present.
What? Why?
We've been going out for 2 months.
You didn't buy him a Cadbury bar as a present?
Well, 2 months is a big deal in high school, let's be real.
He doesn't want a candy bar. Your boyfriend wants, loosen up my button. Like, that's what he wants.
Nick and Charlie have been smooching at school a lot, but Nick has not come out yet. This is crazy. I feel like, well, because I'm 50. And I just...
And that's why we shouldn't kiss at school.
Being gay is not hard. Straight people make being gay hard.
Did someone deliver something?
Did we invite someone else?
The gang's all together at a slumber party at Charlie's house.
Hi.
Oh, that bitch. Remember the girl with the blonde pieces in the front?
You love gay people, so you're an ally.
I kind of had something that I want to tell you. What? It's kind of hard to...
Is it about you and Charlie?
Thank you. Love it when they just say it and you don't have to.
I should have let you say it. It's just... It is kind of obvious.
That's like when you're gay and you're not, you know, I'm not visibly gay.
Yeah, no
shit. I came out to people, I'm forcing everyone to do a performance.
Yeah, they're like...
Where they don't go,
oh, wow.
Girl, we been knew.
Right, right.
My old mom was like, girl, we knew.
Yeah, I know. It's so humiliating in a way.
It is. It's worse. You're forcing them to participate in it. I think in the future, kids will just go to their moms and go, girl.
If you know, you know.
Yeah. And the mom will go, girl. And that's it. And that's it.
Yeah. Mama, girl. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, well, now you know about Charlie, you have to tell me about your crush.
Fine, okay. It's Ben.
Oh, no.
Yeah, but she doesn't know about that.
Oh. Are they texting right next to each other?
Edging. Gooning.
Gooning at the phone.
I told her. Oh my God. Hot, 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 hot. Coming out is a lot harder than I thought, babes.
Babes, it's really hard.
Now, if you're watching this show and you don't understand them, they are speaking English. It's just hard to understand.
Yeah, it's just a different type of English. Old English.
Look at the outlets in the UK. Still don't understand them. Been going there 5 times a year for 10 years.
Those three
still
prongs,
don't understand how to use those.
The three prongs with the squares. I'm like, what
and
are y'all
a switch,
doing?
An outlet with a switch? What are we doing here? Not to mention, to use that outlet, you have to go to the door of the hotel and put your key card in.
I'm from Yorkshire.
I'm from Leeds.
Yeah, yeah.
I just had a facial and Botox.
So I said to my wife, would you like to eat me Yorkshire pudding?
I'm going to do everything I can to make sure Nick doesn't have to deal with what I did.
What I know about coming out is you can totally control other people's reactions.
Absolutely. He's going to be fine. Someone who looks like that is not exactly have the cards stacked against him.
Yeah, I mean, if you're a high schooler, but you're like hot and athletic, your coming out story is going to be a little easier than if you're Miss Music over here.
Mama, yeah, Miss Curly Q.
I see he's still as desperate as ever.
Told you not to talk about him.
Okay, so Ben and Nick get in trouble talking during study hall, and Nick reminds him that he assaulted Charlie.
Because you literally assaulted him.
The way that I would ride that teacher. Oh,
yeah.
Sorry. Yeah.
No, I would too.
Yeah.
There's one person over 18 we're allowed to be attracted to, okay? Uh-huh. It's the teacher.
Yeah.
British people don't look right, and that's what's kind of hot about it. You know what I mean? There's something there that you're like, so crunchy, so delicious. You know what I mean? I mean, this is the oldest DNA, you know?
Mm, and it shows.
Yeah.
You hurt him, and who knows if you do the same with Imogen? Do you even like her? Sorry, am I not allowed to like girls as well as boys?
Frothing discussions of bisexuality happening right on the television screen. Bisexual is really, it just needs to be more. Because people have not caught up to it.
I assume everyone's bisexual till they tell me different.
Boom. That's the way it ought to be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Get out.
And Nick's brother is also home from uni and has no idea that he's bi.
That's Chris Lilly.
That's Dax Shepard.
Charlie. Who's Charlie?
Oh, no.
Yeah, your girlfriend named Charlie.
That's something we never do.
You don't steal each other's phones and read texts?
No, no, no.
Absolutely not.
No, we don't do that. Elle is touring an art school that she's going to apply to next term.
I'm Elle.
And she meets some new friends, Naomi and Felix.
Hey. I just hate being at a regular school. Like everyone knowing you as the trans girl. Here I could just be Naomi. Do you know what I mean?
This is like Star Trek The Next Generation for me.
So in what way?
So removed from my reality.
Oh, yeah.
In my high school, there was not even a gay person, never
no
mind
kidding.
A trans person.
I know. I can't imagine. I'm happy, but I actually can't transplant myself into high school and understand that.
Nope.
Because look how far we've come.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have enough gay trauma that when I see gay people kissing on TV, my impulse is to go, well, that's gay.
Yeah, or people like, where are the men with bats like coming to beat the shit? You know, I know that's grim, but it's real life.
Being a teenager sucks in general.
Of course.
This gay shit complicates everything. Yeah. But being a teenager base level sucks.
It does help, though, when you don't have to deal with the constant threat of imminent violence.
I like Elle.
I don't believe anybody with this hair would be that self-conscious.
Mama, Cindy Lou Who. She came from Whoville to tell them what the tea is.
What is this vibe? What is it?
The Grinch. He stole Christmas.
But I'm going to tell her. Help me.
Well, first we're gonna chop off those little dookies.
The power I could bring to your life with just snip.
Yeah.
If I was his friend right now, they'd be like, I love Elle. I'd be like, all right, if you're gonna tell her, let's get you a haircut.
Fashion montage makeover.
Did you wanna come to that end of exams party tonight?
Oh, yeah, okay.
Is this real?
Is this a fantasy school?
It is a fantasy school, but
I know that kids now are like, cool.
But I don't know.
Can we all quieten down a little bit, please?
Okay, Mr. Farouk can let me know exactly what time it is.
Yeah, and also, so the folks at home know, I would fuck both of them until they were blue in the face. We'll now ask you. Ooh la 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 la.
People you share hotel rooms with.
And we've been told to inform you that boys and girls cannot share rooms.
No.
The gays! They said.
They're like.
But you know what though, this shit is so wholesome. I bet they're gonna have a room to themselves with sexy music playing and red lighting, condoms, lube, and I bet you they're gonna get in bed and hold hands. They're gonna stand down the hall from each other, completely clothed, and go. Like when my boyfriend used to come visit during college, we would sleep in the same room because no one would tell me not to. I remember my family being like, you're not sleeping in the bed with your girlfriend until you're married.
Of course, right.
And meanwhile, I'd be upstairs.
Yeah.
F***ing and sucking
dick
turds.
And cock. There better be a slow-mo reveal of the new haircut. He walks in with long blonde extensions.
Is there a haircut?
Yes, there is. Oh, wow. Darling.
Hair matters.
I like you romantically, and I was wondering if you wanted to go on a date.
This is a huge moment for Tao, but also for Elle, it's pretty big.
So the kids go to the party and Elle and Tao are on their date. Oh, we're gonna burn the gay people's bodies later. That's like my mind went to
that. Seriously.
Your name is on this fire pit.
This is a long con to get them comfortable enough to burn them at the stake.
Leaps and bounds better looking without that hair.
Mama.
I didn't know you invited them.
So Elle and Tao's date did not go great because he was not himself, because he put way too much pressure on himself.
Listen, in romance, it's very easy to get in your own way.
Yes. Move, bitch. Get out your way.
You're the one who's completely different. You've gone off with your new friends and have forgotten I exist completely.
You're the one who said we'd always put our friendship first.
Well, I guess romance does ruin friendship.
Drama. Oh, now the gay people are being burnt.
Yep. That was the yep. curly one's yeah. body being thrown on top of the heat.
I just needed to talk to you guys about something.
You're bisexual, so you're gonna cheat on my brother.
I hope he's okay. Nick is having a lot of anxiety coming out, and a lot of the homophobia, and especially the bi erasure, is messing with his head.
It's hard. Listen,
Mama, the bi erasure is real.
It's very real.
Especially among gay people.
Oh, yes. I pity all of this because as somebody who's been with a lot of straight guys now, when I talk about being gay and how long I've been gay and how everyone knows I'm gay, the look in their eyes is so like,
how
they could never.
Yeah, like, how did you grow that third leg?
But it's all in their brains.
Oh, yeah.
I feel really ill. I'm taking you home.
This actor with the curly hair, I think he could do runway or something, or print modeling.
Oh, Calvin Klein, easy.
Fashion.
I made you tea.
Yeah. What's gonna happen? Nothing.
Maybe they'll hold both hands.
Ooh. If we're in the beginning of our relationship and we're together in a room in bed, we're having sex.
I was gonna say, but I didn't want to be gross.
No, we're having
sex.
I was
like, that's the only thing that's happening.
I'm not even happy in relationships where someone doesn't want to have sex as much as me.
Right.
So this teenage hand-holding?
It's,
girl.
Like I said, this is 3037 in the planet Voltron.
I think there's this idea that when you're not straight, you have to tell all your friends and family immediately. But you don't.
You don't owe anyone anything.
Absolutely not. Also, it's nobody's business what you're doing. You know what I mean?
Well, when we talk about in gay world, we talk about sexual like freedom, but we also need to talk about the freedom to be private or yes. prude or like...
First of all, they don't need to know that you're sucking dick and cock because it's really none of their business.
Well, not to mention, Mary, it's high school. Tell one person.
Yeah.
And let the rest...
Disseminate the information,
out.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. You have to share beds.
The school trip to Paris is underway, and their friends prevent Charlie and Nick from sleeping in the same bed.
I hate being woken up by the sun.
No, I'm sorry. I would say to them, you guys know that we're sleeping in the same bed together.
It's like, wait a minute.
Their own friends don't want them to sleep
apart. Four people are sleeping in that room?
Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
Win beds?
Mary.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Ooh, and our favorite art teacher and science teacher are sharing a room.
Is something teacher gay gonna happen?
Well, I hope so, because I need to see somebody have sex, and it better not be kids.
Right. They really did take over Paris.
Okay, gang, today, you
get oh my God.
Montmartre.
We went there, so fabulous.
Beautiful.
So beautiful.
I agree with what you said. Things were better when we were just friends.
Tao and Elle still really like each other, but they go back to the safety of just being friends.
I'm happy you're making new friends, but I just-
Musée de Montmartre, chapitre 2.
Chapitre 2, écoute.
Yeah, dialogue. Ils se tombent amoureux l'un avec l'autre.
Le pop quiz.
Pop quiz.
Why are you in a mood with me?
Because you're supposed to be my boyfriend.
At dinner, Charlie is seated next to Ben, and Imogen notices that the vibes are off.
I don't know why you're obsessed with Charlie.
Because Ben kind of likes Charlie still.
You're a terrible mm-hmm. boyfriend. I'm breaking up with you.
Charlie has that magic pussy.
That's fine. You don't have to be such a bitch about it.
Work.
Oh, so you hate women?
There's no need to call her a bitch.
Imogen, by the way, cannot catch a break.
I wish this were real.
Oh, in real life, no one would ever not side with him. Imogen needs to stop getting wrapped up in these wishy-washy men.
Yeah.
Find someone who wants to be with you, bitch.
I've indicated that I'm receptive to an offer. I've cleared the month of June, and I am, after all, me.
Did you just post another photo of me on Instagram?
Charlie and Nick get some alone time. Which doesn't mean much.
Are we jaded?
No. I think we're just, I'm just old.
I'm trying to anchor myself in reality. Oh God. It's like a weird thing because I don't want to see teenagers have sex.
Oh my soul, oh my heavens.
I will punch you in the mouth if something doesn't develop. I will punch you in the mouth.
No, not before I'm jumping into a wood chipper. I'm jumping into a wood chipper and spraying
you
with
edging, and then there's whatever this is. Look at the lighting design, though. Beautiful.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
It's HPV.
Is that? It's KS.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to.
The hickey really shook me.
Forgive I can't believe I've done this.
The Unthinkable. This is Alicia Keys. This is that song. What is that one?
You Don't Know My Name? Hey, it's that waitress. You always come in and get the special. Yeah,
the hot chocolate.
I'm the waitress with the brain.
Hold on, my phone is breaking up.
Okay. My manager always be tripping because I'd be using real milk for you.
You don't know my name.
The problem with hickeys is covering it with makeup can make it worse.
Also, it's crazy. I don't want to put on makeup. Like.
Oh my God. You. I cannot believe it. The actual.
I'm going to have to loosen my quads for this.
This
because
is
I'm going to run
agenda.
Out of the studio.
This is the woke
in
agenda.
In high heels like Sarah Jessica Parker down Madison Avenue to the fucking sale at Barney's, bitch. Running up that hill out the studio.
I'm just going to stretch out because that way if anything happens I don't like, I can whoosh.
Yeah. And you put me out of my fucking misery. The magical framework of this different planet is crazy, but they're a fabulous actor.
And you know what? They have to be good actors because they're pulling off scenarios that would never occur in a high school.
I think this is like retroactively healing for like 3 to 4 generations of people.
Yeah.
You know, that's not what I meant. Remember when we were walking into Truro?
No, not really.
I mean, okay, to be fair, I fell in love with a guy when I was 16, and it was the most important thing in my life.
Mm-hmm.
That feeling cannot be overstated.
Of course.
The person was magical.
And being young and feeling these feelings for the first
time. Didn't sleep all night.
Amplifies everything.
I was like, didn't sleep all night. It was like, was like better than drugs.
Everyone pose for me now. Wait, that's the Mona Lisa. That's it. It's Robin.
There's Beyonce, and then there's Heartstopper.
Yeah.
They can both get to shut down the fucking Louvre and look at the Mona Lisa, which, by the way, very overhyped, very unimpressive. Teeny little painting.
Vous avez visité le Louvre?
Oui, et j'ai vu la Joconde.
C'est petit, trop petit.
C'est petit.
Charlie, what's wrong?
Kiki, mama. It's kind of giving that, like something scary is about
to happen. It is, yeah. Catch, oh yes, fall into his arms.
Charlie loves the drama.
Miss Music is like,
Miss
she's
Music
wrapped
is about
up.
The drama. She,
yeah.
What's gayer than fainting at the Louvre?
They should make more movies in the Louvre. I can only think of the Da Vinci Code, and you would literally have to
Tao and Elle have been having a wonderful time at the Louvre. Oh, and they get to share their first kiss in France, the city of love.
I mean, I guess kissing in Paris at the Louvre in high school
is
very
cool.
Cute. Good for them.
Mama, if it was 1999, if there was one single other f*** in my high school in France with me,
it would have been,
on site.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've noticed you don't really eat a lot.
Oh no, does he have an ED?
Some days I'm fine, but other days I feel like I need to control it.
Oh my God. I don't think I've ever had a frank, mature, direct conversation in my life.
Compared to them? No.
Yeah. I mean,
I usually do the shitty version of what they're doing and then wish I had done what they're doing.
Yeah.
That's usually what I do.
I'm sneaking around like that.
Nothing could stop me from eating that teacher's ass. Homo moment.
Is everyone gay?
Yes. In this universe, 90% of people are gay and 10% are hetero.
Tend to miss out on those beautiful gay teenage experiences.
Sweetie, honey, it's never too late to suck dick and cock.
I have a lot of friends who came out very late.
Yeah, I had a, I know people
know
who are married
to women.
You
know what
they become? What?
30-year-old sluts.
Yeah. Sluts.
Everybody who's like Jehovah's Witness till 28, blown out by 30.
Blown out cow pussies.
It's Tara's birthday and their last night in Paris, so they throw a party in the girls' hotel room. Isaac has his first ever kiss with James, and he does not like it.
Now, here's another little nice little nugget of reality. Sometimes it's not good.
Yeah.
Just because they're gay doesn't mean you're going to like them.
Is this pro-gay or anti-gay?
It's anti-sex.
It's anti-sex. I feel like there's a stereotype that in Gen Z, everybody's like so woke that they're all gay even if they're not gay. Oh, maybe they're not gay.
No, it's they're like, I don't want to see sex. It doesn't further the plot. Do you know what I mean?
They're the no-cake at pride people.
Yes, they're like, they are the new generation of like Prudence Clearwater from-
Prudence Clearwater Revival. Prudence Clearwater Revival.
Who gave you the hickey?
Damn.
Gag.
What? Can we just move on from this?
This is drama. These bitches are about the drama.
Yeah, yeah.
He can't be honest because he can't come out for this person, right?
Me. We're dating.
Oh my God. I fucking knew you were a perf.
He's a gay man now.
He's a gay man.
We're okay with people knowing.
And we're pregnant. They're saying it like they're pregnant. Do you know what I mean? They're like,
we just put the down payment down on a condo and
we did IVF.
Yeah.
Is this okay? I'm not sure I'm ready to do anything more than kissing.
I can't fucking
fucking take it anymore. What are we watching?
Was this filmed for PBS?
We're watching Peanuts.
Peanuts.
This is the Mother Goose suite.
It's Mother Goose. Are y'all new?
Mama.
My favorite thing about having a high school romance is hand-holding. Why would we f when we can smile at each other?
I didn't think we'd do that right now.
They need Lana Del Rey in their life.
Take off all your clothes. Take me to death.
Love me until I love myself.
My pussy tastes like Pepsi Cola.
Yeah.
If you didn't ever want to do it, then I wouldn't either.
We don't ever have to do it. Oh, Why don't we just hold hands at the post office?
I think that's a better idea.
Pissing still okay, though?
I feel like all these like teenagers who love this show are gonna be mad that we want them to have sex. But I don't want them to have sex because I want to watch teenagers have sex. I want it to be closer to real.
Coercing anybody into having sex is, of course, a terrible thing. I think we're advocating for more of a realistic approach to what is generally considered to be the truth.
For every character so far, the story has sort of let them blossom at their own speed.
Oh,
that's great. Which I guess is really good.
Many people feel pressured to fuck people. There's whole movies about this.
Well, that was very our generation.
Yeah, that's like,
very our generation.
Get him to the Greek.
Now, Gen Z now is like, oh, you guys had sex?
Yeah.
It's disgusting.
I love you.
Drunk Tina. Oh, it's the UK. People are dead drunk by 4 p.m.
Yeah. They always are looking at each other like they're about to eat each other's faces. I'm not joking. When they do these scenes, they're like this.
Yeah, they're like, it's crazy. They're like trying to suck in each other's breath. It's so wild.
You could just share my bed.
At the moment he says that, I can't get up from the bed because, you know what?
Yes, my snail trail has sent me to the duvet.
No, both beds are soiled.
Yeah, and this one's worse. Finally, he's so cute, it would be over.
He's so sexy.
Yeah, gorgeous. All right, it's the art show at what is going to be Elle's new school. So Isaac really identifies with a piece of art and he learns about being ace or asexual.
Oh, is that what they're calling
An
it?
An often overlooked type of sexuality.
Basically about my experience being aromantic and asexual. Being in a world where romance and sex are prized above everything else when you don't feel those forms of attraction.
Actually, this is a teachable moment for me.
Oh yeah.
Something about you is different, but you don't have the words to describe what that is.
This is wonderful for all you sophomores and juniors and seniors in high school. Wish I had it when I was there.
Euphoria of freeing yourself from those pressures and expectations.
Gag on this tea, hunty. The freedom from desire is the key to enlightenment. Things finally come to a head between Charlie and Ben. This little weasel.
I know I was a piece of shit, but I really liked you. My parents would never accept who I really am. I'm sorry for everything.
Oh, God.
I think this is a good apology, right?
It's really good.
Sorry doesn't make up for everything you did to me.
I kind of feel bad for both of them.
Damn.
Ben was like, the intention I think was there.
Miss Music's letting them have it. Don't bully. If you f with the dolls, you can't f the dolls.
Thank you.
You know what I mean?
But your surname is so English.
So Nick and his mom, Sarah, have Charlie and his whole family over for dinner. Nick's dad, Stefan, the Frenchman, and his brother, David, are there as well.
Dad, has Nick told you how he met Charlie?
Oh, work.
No, he hasn't.
Work, bitch. Just say Grindr.
Yeah.
Have neither of you boys found girlfriends?
Yeah, I'm not sure Nick's too interested in looking for girlfriends, really.
Don't you dare.
What is this brother doing?
He's trying to be a fucking asshole.
I don't like that.
No, his brother's a dickwad.
Surprise. I'm bi, he's gay, and I was actually really stressed out about how I was gonna tell you. But you know what? I don't care what you think about it anymore.
Work, bitch. No response. And then he's like, and we're also really into the Zodiac. And the dad's like, oh, God.
Yeah. Actually, I've done your chart and I really want to go over some things with you.
This is the time when you might actually take an interest in my life, but.
Oh, that table turned red.
The truth is you can't control what your family's going to do or say with this shit, but you can control how you respond. Mm-hmm. And I wish everybody could respond the way he just did.
I know.
Let him speak to us like that.
Oh, David, be quiet. We've heard quite enough from you. Thank
it's
you.
It's Nick that's making a scene.
I want Charlie's mom to be like, drama.
That is an awkward situation to be in.
Very.
Mom, I would have boot scooted out of the window.
Out the window, levitated.
You know what it would have been?
In Hereditary, when Payman has decapitated, the body floats out the window. That would have been me leaving that situation.
Hail Payman, bitch.
Hail Payman.
Drama queen boyfriend's influence. Yeah, mate, it works.
kick the phone. Work! Work.
You are a pathetic little man.
Take the earbuds out and jam them into the eyes.
Talk about my brother like that again, and I'll end you.
The goths are not homophobic, traditionally, right?
Abso-f***ing-lutely not.
Yeah.
No.
The goths are allies, the OG allies.
Because the goths are on the outside, the fringes, they're often bisexual.
Yeah. Oh, you drink cum, I drink blood.
Yeah, like...
Come over here.
Exactly.
When straight kids have gay parents, do they come out? I'm not being funny. No.
No,
it's just assumed. No. Yeah. It's assumed that they're
straight. You are straight,
straight
anyway. Until proven gay.
Okay. If I had a straight kid, I would play out all these scenarios. Like, I found this copy of Reservoir Dogs in your room. What, next you're gonna go out with a girl? Now, did your brother care when he found out?
My brother? Oh, yeah. No. My brother knew.
Because sister and mom is easy. I do think brother is hard and dad is hard.
Brother and dad couldn't be more tolerant. I'm very spoiled. Very,
really?
Very spoiled.
When I told my brother I was gay, we were driving in a truck. Mm-hmm. I was in the passenger seat, he was driving. Mm-hmm. He was like, so you got any girlfriends at school? And I said, no. And he says, you don't really notice the girls at school? And I said, no. And he goes, what are you not into girls? And I said, no, before I could even think about it.
Wow.
And then they would pause and then he goes, are you into guys? And I go, yes. And we're both staring at the road. No one looks at anyone, right? And then there's a long pause and I go, are you mad? Because I was like so scared. I was like 18.
Oh yeah.
And he goes, no, and he said something about tomatoes, which was crazy. He goes, I don't like tomatoes. I think eating tomatoes is kind of gross, but I'm never going to tell people not to eat tomatoes.
Oh my God, what a mensch.
Which I thought was mind-blowing.
What a mensch.
And then I went, you me. And I didn't even look at him, he didn't look at me. He reaches over, puts his hand on my shoulder, and he goes, you're still my brother. None of that matters.
Oh, waterworks, Niagara Falls.
And now watching this, Niagara I'm realizing Falls. At the time, if that had gone differently, that would have been extremely horrible for me.
Oh, yeah.
He was the first, I told him before my mom, before anyone, I guess.
Oh, wow.
But thinking back now, I'm like, this would have murdered me. I wouldn't even have been able to stand up for myself the way
he
just did.
No.
Charlie didn't eat very much.
Okay, so Charlie did not eat again at the dinner party.
So Nick is going to use Google to try to understand eating disorders. And I just want everyone to know that Googling things is normal.
It's very crazy.
Now, in season one of Heartstopper, I got dragged in the comments for laughing at someone Googling, am I gay?
Yeah. In her day, she went to the library, pulled out the card catalog, and then...
The only hope I had was to pick up the phone, dial zero, and wait.
Can you connect me with a gay person?
Can you connect with a gay person in my area?
Fashion's biggest night at Heartstopper prom, and Nick decides to come out on Instagram as bisexual because this is how the kids are going to be doing it these days. It's like a press release.
Coming out the morning of prom is psychotic.
And I love it.
She wants to come out the morning of prom so she can walk into that cafeteria with a disco ball and go, my name is Bella Hadid. Like, she's really trying to, like, frame prom around herself.
She's trying to take all those spotlights and direct them right, oh, man.
She said, bisexuals at prom, here I am. So Tao and Elle rule the dance floor, honey.
All the f***s are gagging on their tea.
Oh, look at the little hearts. Aww.
Heartstopper.
I wish I would have went to prom with a boy.
Honey, if I could go back.
Gowns.
Beautiful gowns.
Yeah.
Gorgeous gowns.
All right, so after everyone leaves, Nick and Charlie talk about how Charlie's doing. I can't take any more hugging.
I can't do it.
You know, it's prom, we're alone. I think we should have another heartfelt discussion.
Yeah.
I used to cut myself sometimes.
This is for the kids.
I mean,
this is for the kids. This
no
the
jokes kid. Allowed here. No, self-mutilation is never the option.
No. And it is frequent. Listen, like, I was a cutter, whatever. It's very sad. It's very common. It's very sophomore in high school.
Yes.
You know?
I'm sure it's way more common for gay people.
Of course.
Way
yeah. More common. Or people who feel, you know, whatever.
I love your hair so much. I really need to go.
I love your eyes.
To quote one of the greats, if you can't love yourself, right? You have to have self-love.
It doesn't matter if you have the hottest, beefiest, most tolerant, bisexual hunk in the world.
And supportive parents.
Yes.
You have to love yourself.
Yeah. You got to put on the brightest shade of eyeshadow and become a superhero diva.
Actually, your eye makeup looks great today.
Thank you.
I'm being driven insane by this fucking show. Like, this show is gonna haunt me. I'm gonna start seeing cartoon leaves, bitch. Like, So Charlie leaves Nick's house, and this is the cliffhanger. Does he text him that he loves him or not? Girl, just let it happen.
Don't try to understand it. Mama. Let these 12-year-old British f***ets have their little Three Bears storyline, girl. Let them have their Baird's.
Let Mother Bears. Goose waddle down the street, honey. Let them
have their busy world of Richard Scarry, honey. Let them have their Blues Clues.
Make way for Ducklings, honey.
Honey, let them have their comfy couch, honey. Girl. Well, this show has everything.
It certainly did not have one thing.
Yeah, if you're afraid of watching something with too much gay intimacy, you came to the right place.
Hello. It had hugging.
It had homophobia.
Goth sisters.
Yeah, it had a prom.
It had some gay teachers. Ooh, La France.
It had pretty much every expression of sexuality contained in one small high school friend group.
Well, it's certainly trying and it's a wonderful effort. Also, it had incredible acting by very talented, wonderful child actors.
Like, of course it did. It had consensual, loving, healthy expressions of love.
Yeah, beautiful, wonderful examples of tolerance, compassion, and beauty.
And that's why I had nothing to relate to.
Thank you.
So check out Heartstopper on Netflix, season 2.
Oh, yeah.
Au revoir.
Merci beaucoup.
À demain. À la prochaine.